Yeah, we are moving to the next step in the what's Olam Haba. In short, we did last week's that Rambam says Olam Haba is neshames only. The Ravid, which is, by the way, everyone that speaks about this topic refers to the Ramban. The Ramban in the Kapis is later. We saw just the Ravid, but the main shite that is chaylik on the Rambam is the Ramban in Shara Gmul. He goes straight away that Olam Haba is neshames with bodies, and that's Trias Amesim. Chassidus paskin with the Ramban. The Rebbe, I have it here in the end of this Kapis, the Rebbe brings all the places of Chassidus. Sometimes the Alter Rebbe quotes only the Ramban. And the Rebbe is using it as a proof that Chassidus goes like the Ramban. But the Ravid also, by the way, last week we spoke about the Ravid himself. The Ravid says on the Rambam, how can you say that it's without bodies? We see here and here and here and here and here. It all goes referring to the body and Chias Amesim. And so what is the Ravid going to do with the Gemore? The whole thing over here is based on a Gemore that Rav says, Olam Haba im bolei achile v'lei shtiye. But the Rambam takes it in this most simple way. There is no achile, no shtiye, there is no body. And the Ravid says, there is other ways. Elion Ovi went up with his body to the Shamayim, and there is no food over there. In a different halacha that we saw last week, so the Ravid, the Rambam again, speaks about the Seudo, the famous Seudo of Moshiach. Not the Seudo of Moshiach, the Seudo that the Ebishter is going to, not necessarily the Seudo of Moshiach, the Seudo that the Ebishter is going to make to the Tzadikim Le'osid Lovay. Le'osid Lovay in Olam Haba is the all referring to the same time of Olam Haba. So the Rambam says the Seudo is also a Moshel. So the Ravid says, if the Seudo is a Moshel, what is everything that is said over there that it's going to be a Brikas Amozen? The Ebishter will offer all the tzaddikim to bench Avraham, Yitzchak, Yaakov. Each one of them will say, I am not because of this reason or that reason. Till David HaMelech. So what is the Kosher Brocha? What is the Brikas Amozen if there is no food? But the Ravid himself, we asked last week, the Ravid himself said also that there is no food in the. So if you look carefully, the Ravid is not saying there is no food. The Ravid is speaking about the problem. If you have a problem, the fact that there is no food and there is a body, you should know, we found many cases that there is food, there is a body, there is no food. So the Ravid is not saying that there will not be food in Olam Haba. It's just telling you, if you're afraid of this Gemara, of the Memor of Rav, at the Mephoshim of the Rambam, they all bring the Rambam, and they also said, why is it so important? There is many Gemoras that they say it's a different opinion. Why everyone here is so careful to fit this shita with Rav, that there is no achile v'lo ishtiye, tzadikim yoishvim v'atarasem b'roshem v'nenem izav ashchine. So one of the Mephoshim Rambam says, it's because this Rav is being caught few times, and it's being said few times, and this is not just, you could say, there is different opinions. This is something very basic, which you must consider it. You can't just get away without answering what it says of it. There's no lechel v'leishtiyah. Today we'll go to the next step in this machlokes, and soon we'll get into the Ramban. Aloha Ches, the last aloha we copied from the Rambam. What about what? Aloha Ches, you will see. So, to finalize the Rambam's shite, we brought Aloha Ches. Ze shekoru eser chachomim oilam abo. Oilam abo is a simple word, the world to come. It's the next world, it's not happening today. So the Rambam says, "Lo mipnei she'eino imotzo yato," not because, doesn't mean that this is not, doesn't exist today, this world. Ve'ze olam oived, so we need first to wait till this world is gone, and then it's coming the other world. No. V'chayach yavo oisei olam. Ein adavor kein. That's not the case. This Olam Haba exists today, and again, the simple way everyone learns the Rambam, that Olam Haba is what we call Gan Eden. The Gan Eden exists today. Avraham Avinu is in Gan Eden, Yitzchak Avinu is in Gan Eden. Today I hear a sicha of the Rebbe from, the end of the Shlumin of Tav Shimem. The Rebbe, the later years, the Rebbe forbanked the night of Yud Beis Sivan. Yud Beis Sivan is the end of the Tashlumin. So the Rebbe, Bein Advarim, or in this forbanking, or the forbanking of Erev Shavuos, Tav Shimem. The Rebbe said, the Rebbe said, no, it was actually in the end of the Tashlumin. The Rebbe spoke about the satellite, that it's Mischaber, many Yidden from many places are joining together, it gives koyach to the Achlotes Toivas of the forbanking. So the Rebbe says, also, we are connected with the Rabbeim, with the Neshamas is in Gan Eden. So this Gan Eden is basically every Yid, after he's finishing his Shivim Shana, Shmoyim Shana, Meir Ve'esrim Shana, in the Namaze, he goes to Gan Eden. So it exists today. It's just the individual person, he has it after he's finishing his term. In this world, he's going there. But the both worlds exist at the same time. So that's what the Rambam says. Ha'ala ariyu motzi v'ayimet, shenemach shatzifanto l'riyacho pa'alto, ולא יקראו אולם הבא, what's been אולם הבא, the world to come, אבל מפני שהאויס המחיים, this Gan Eden comes to the person אחר חי אולם הזה, שלא קיים בו בגוף הנפש, וזהו נמצא לא יודעים בכל הדבר ראשונה. Obviously, the Ravid, what's the problem? If the Rambam speaks about Gan Eden, so it's all good. The Ramban says that אולם הבא is Trias Amesim, the Rambam says אולם הבא is Gan Eden, so each one called it a different name. The Ravid, if you remember, all of his questions on the Rambam, they're coming from the same point. Because Olam Haba is usually referring to Tchias HaMeisim, so the Ravid has a problem with every single thing the Rambam says about Olam Haba, how it fits with Tchias HaMeisim. So it seems like the Ravid actually is not taking the Rambam as Gan Eden. He's kind of taking the Rambam, yeah, and Tchias HaMeisim. And then, what's going on over here? We have the life here in the world, Neshamas Begufim. Then, if Chas V'Shalom, somebody passed away, he's starting the world of the... I'm sorry, of Neshamas Beloi Gufim, Gan Eden. Then Tchias HaMeisim, Neshamas Begufim again. And that's Olam Haba. So the Ravid says, Omar Avrom, Niro Kemakrish, the Rambam's opinion, the Rambam's way, looks like it's contradicting with the fact Shein Olam Chazor Letoyu Vavoyu. What did the Rambam said? Olam Haba is not something after this world finished. They both exist at the same time. We have a Gemore, Shis Alfei Shnin Ave Olme. The world was created to be 6,000 years, and we have 220 years till the end of this 6,000. The Chad Choruv. What is Chad Choruv? The 7,000 is going to be the world to be gone. It's going to be gone. Choruv, destroy it. Chad, this 1,000 year, the 7,000 year, which is the Shabbos of Klolus Abriye, every 1,000 year is one day. Elef Shonim Beinecho Kerim Esmoel. 1,000 year is by the Eibishter, one day. If you remember, the Rebbe said many times in the Sichas, we are now in Erev Shabbos Achar Chatzos. We are in the 6,000, after the 500, where the Hashem Tov Gilui Achzidus started by Chatzos of Friday, when Shabbos usually is starting by Chatzos. We're getting close to the Elef HaShvi. What's Elef HaShvi? You have what the Alter Rebbe said, we will see it later. But the Ravid learns to the Elef HaShvi is a time of Tchias HaMeisim of Olam Haba. So if the Rambam says this is not happening after the 6,000 years, so when? When is it going to happen? That's the Ravid's question. You're saying the Olam Haba and the Olam Haza they both exist in the same time? So what's with Olam Haba? There is a Gemara that says clearly, after the 6,000 years, it's going to be a different status of the world, which Chassidus explained it very well, in a different way. What is the Rambam going to do with that? That's his question. What is Chad Choruv?
Yeah.
So, this is the time of Olam Haba. Why is it called Choru? This is a different shiur. It's not for today. This is a all shiur by its own. But in general, Moshe Moshiach is from now, from the second Moshiach is Mizgale. But Moshe Moshiach, according to the Rambam, according to the way it's been taken in general, is either way, if you will have miracles or not, it's still Olam Haza Agashmi. It's going to be live people doing mitzvahs. It's going to be. There is much to talk about in Moshe Moshiach. Venizke, Venichi, Venira, Lishnei Moshe Moshiach, the years of Moshe Moshiach, Ulechai Olam Haba. Olam Haba is the world to come after Moshe Moshiach, which is the Elef Hashvi. This is agreed by almost everyone. The Rambam says that the Rambam is contradicting this basic Gemara. One second. It's not today, but I will not have you wait another 200 years to understand this, but not today. But the Alter Rebbe says clearly that the Elef Hashvi, he brings from the Arizal, Elef Hashvi is the time of the Schar. The Schar for all the mitzvahs did all the years. And this is Olam Haba, the Elef Hashvi. And this is Tchiyas HaMeisim. Now, we finish with the Rambam. What? Ikar Schar. Yeah. Now we're going to the Rambam. The main shite that is Cholek on the Rambam is the Rambam. And he has an all long thing in Shara Gmul. We just caught the main pieces, the main paragraphs, which are saying his main shita, where is Cholek on the Rambam. By the way, the Ramban, besides having a machlokes with the Rambam, is also giving an idea, which we will see in the end, that the Rambam has all of them. The Rambam has Olam Haba as Gan Eden, which is existing today, and the Rambam is also Olam Haba after Tchiyas HaMeisim. Another one, also without Gufim. Whatever, we'll see. The Ramban, he brings the Rambam, אבל ירואה מכוון השרב זכרנו לברוכו, which is the Rambam, שאולם אבו אצלו משמש לכל עול מן השומץ. Olam Haba is a general name to everything has to do with the neshomes. ולכל המגיע עליהם לידי יד. והנה ימים באמס, the Rambam, there is no question. The Rambam himself, he quotes 13 principles of faith in the Akdome of Perik Chelik and Sanhedrin. Principle of faith is something that if somebody does not believe in one of them, he is a koifer. He is not a koifer in a single mitzvah, he is a koifer in the entire Torah. Because those 13 principles, they are foundations of Yiddishkeit. And each one of them has to do with the entire Torah. Like Torah min HaShamayim and everything. So the Rambam says, Tchiyas HaMeisim is Ikar Mikri HaTorah. And the Rebbe once said in Asiche, that even though our minig is not to say every morning after Shachar the 13 principles, like that Rebbe didn't put it in the Siddur, nevertheless, there is no, we have, this is a something basic in Yiddishkeit, and everyone agree, and everyone is mechuyev to believe in it. They don't say it. שויקר מיקרי התורה, הכוון הבוי, שתושב הנפש לגוף ברצון הבוי. The body and soul will unite together again. וייצא הנשומס לנעולם הבו. The nishomis will leave Gan Eden, where there was some of them are over 3,000 years. ויושוב על הגוף, go back to the body, בימי תחייס המסר. ויסעדנו האנושים מהם, הזויכים בטבע סוילם הזה במויס המשיח, whoever is alive in Moshiach HaMashiach, our generation, the merchant will greet Moshiach, will be alive, will not come to Tchiyas HaMeisim just as a neshome. The Yizku boy from Moshiach HaMashiach will upgrade and elevate ourselves from the Yizku boy Lemaila El Yonam HaMalos HaMarishoyno. Aval Achrei Kein, it brings the Rambam that after Tchias HaMeisim, they will die again. And it will be again Neshomas without bodies. As a higher stage, and a higher Toive, and a higher Gilui, that cannot be accepted being in the body. So we have, I said it once already, we had four or five stages with the Rambam. And then we'll start the real Olam Haba, which is not Gan Eden. So what's happening over here? The Neshomas left body already once to get Gan Eden. Gan Eden, they can't get it being in the body. Then they will come back to our body in the Moshiach Moshiach. They will do mitzvahs again, but higher mitzvahs. And then to get the reward for the higher mitzvahs, they will die again. And this world is already forever. Okay. So the Ravitz, the Ramban says that the Rambam's shita is, Olam Haba is everything that is related, is affiliated with the Neshome. So we have it twice. We had one time when we're getting schar for the mitzvahs we did in the Shivim Shana, Shmoyim Shana, we did Bezman HaGolos, Mayavayasrim. And then we will get it a second time, which is the Olam Haba that the Rambam speaks. The Rambam speaks again without a body.
Is that what Chassidus agrees with the Rambam?
Chassidus passing with the Rambam. That Olam Haba will be to the Neshamas with bodies.
Yeah, and after Tchias HaMeisim.
By Tchias HaMeisim. By Tchias
HaMeisim
will stay in the body forever, according to Ramban and Chassidus Paskin this way. After Tchias HaMeisim, will not be again any separation of soul and body. And the big Elohim will be in the body and because the body.
How long will Tchias HaMeisim be?
Forever. No, the big Tzadikim will get up first.
Tchias HaMeisim?
When? After Moshiach?
This is different. Again.
According to the Rambam. No. All this is the Ramban brings quotes from the Rambam. Because the Rambam says that Olam Haba is without gufim, without the body, so explain how it's going to work. People are dying, they're getting back to the bodies, and they will die again. But the Ramban now starts his argument with the Rambam. Don't worry. Tchias HaMeisim is forever. That's Chassidus Paskin and that's it. Chassidus said not only that. Not only the body is not a problem, is not blocking the Giluim of Olam Haba, the body in the way it will be in Tchias HaMeisim is going actually to be the reason to the old Giluim. The Neshome is going to be secondary to the body. Today, the body is the body. The Neshome is the Neshome. In Tchias HaMeisim, it will be different. Yom Kippur is a taste of Tchias HaMeisim. Yom Kippur, the Neshome Nezoynes Min HaGuf, but we live, Yom Kippur, we don't need food. Why we don't need food? We live from the Tainug Eliki that the Neshome is on Yom Kippur. Yom Kippur is a very happy day. The way that, it's not now Shir on Yom Kippur, but it has to do a little bit all sugi over here. In the world, Yom Kippur and Asasim Tshuva and Rosh Hashanah is Yom Adin. It's time to tremble for if we'll survive the next year. And we need, okay, Yom Kippur is tshuva, no question. But Yom Kippur is a tremendous, it's kavus of the Eibishter, and it's such a gilui of the Eibishter, that from the pleasure we have from this gilui, that the Eibishter is close to us on Yom Kippur, we don't need to eat it. The Rav Hashem said it once, that we live from the tainug, that's such a yom tov, it's such a tainug, we don't need to eat. Every Yid is not eating on Yom Kippur, and most people you will ask. Yeah, most people they don't even feel it. You know, Yom Kippur goes away, and finish nail and like. Okay, so learn more chassidus. Ay. Good, so we need Moshiach for you. It was not good enough. בספרי הזכירו כל הזמנים הללו, במדרש, אמרו, בישלך החותן חייס לך בעולם הזה, בשוח בחר תשמור עליך, ספיק סבא דתוירה, דמישני פרקי אובס, תשמור עליך בשעה סמיסה, רק יצא ישר בימי המשיח, היא תשכח על העולם הבא. So we have over here the Mise, the Olam Haze, Neshames with Badis, Mana Mise after the separation, the Olam Neshames, which is Gan Eden, and we have the Moshiach and Olam Haba. So we'll move to the next page. Kol Eilu Dvorim Brurim. This is clearly Olam Haba, Omo Bechol Mokrim, Eino Olam Neshames. It now starts the argument with the Rambam. The Ramban, before that, the Ramban was reviewing the Ramban's shita. He got afraid that the Neshamas will die again. Don't worry. Sha'olam Abba Omer b'chol mokim ein olam Neshamas v'asochar amagi alam yad achi amis. This is Gan Eden. There is something else. It's a olam she'oset HaKadosh Baruch Hu l'chadshoy l'achar yomis ha'mashiach tchiyas ha'meisim. Which is the elef ha'shvi. Why do we see him before us in Medrash? He brings a lot about the Aleph Hashvi. By Vorach Elikim Esim Hashvi, Birech HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the Eivishter blessed, the Olam Haba, Shemaschi Be Aleph Hashvi. Vayikadosh HaYisoy, Zimna Le Yisrael, Goyim is no business with the Olam Haba. Olam Haba is only for you. Umishne Zuy Shashaninu Betomid, the end of Maseches Tomid, he brings the Shir of every day, and he says, "Vashvi ma'u aimer." Mizmer shir leim Hashabbos leosid lavoi. Osid lavoi. Rafir salsa to yomayz Moshiach atchias amaisim. Leolam shekulo Shabbos. It's such a world, which is called chorv destroyed. But this is in a very positive mean destroyed. Destroyed, not people who put an atom bomb and destroy everything exists. It's going to be chorv. The Alter Rebbe explained what's been chorv. We'll get to it. Le'olam shekulo Shabbos. It's a wall that is elevated from everything materially. Shumenucha lechai olam. It's going to be forever. That's why it's called Elef Shano. If it's forever, we'll see. Vaze olam omu bebroches. Meragli bepume de Rav. This is the Rav that everyone is discussing it, and we need to fit it to each one. To each one's shite. Olam Haba, ein bo lo yachile, v'lo yishtiyeh, v'lo yikina, v'lo yisrin, v'lo yisrin, v'lo yitachrus. Elo tzadikim yoshvim v'atrisayim b'rishayim v'einenim mizi v'ashchinim. V'chen yoyimru tomid v'talmud, HaKadosh Baruch Hu masbion mizi v'shchinos al Olam Haba. We're going to enjoy, to nene, to have the pleasure from the gilu yashchin of the Eibishter, which is hiding today. Sh'ne'emar, ezbo b'okit tzmonosecho, r'tzen elo'emar, sh'kiyum ha'anoshim ha'zoichim, בזיו הכובד, is כקיום הנפש בגוף בו ילמז באחיד הרשתיות. The same way that a person, in order to be alive, in order to last, in order to be healthy, needs to eat and drink, we're going to be fitted from the זיו השכינה. We're going to get our energy, our chayus, we're going to get it from the גילוי אלוקוס, that's going to be in Olam Haba. כמו שכוסוב, באור פני מלך חיים. The חיים, where we get chayus from? From the אור פני מלך, from the אבא של השכינה. ויחזו הסלקים ויחלו וישתו. אכילו ודויס, דכסיב באור פני מלך חיים. And the Ramban goes on with his explanation, what does it mean there is no food? Because we're going to get chayus from something else. By the way, even in our days, that we must have some food to stay alive. When a person is really happy, he needs less food. The Friedrich Rebbe once said to the send a shliach, somebody was in the Friedrich Rebbe Anichides, I think it was here in America, and he told them, go to the yeshiva downstairs, and the yeshiva was then in the small zal, and tell them that if you will learn in the way it's supposed to be, so instead of so much bread I need to eat every day, I will need to eat half of it or a quarter of it. This is something gashmi. This is not something. When a person has pleasure, he needs less food. And when a person is marrying off a son or whatever it is, he could go 6 hours and he doesn't even feel. He's so much filled with is so much full with the happiness that he has, but it doesn't need it that much. This is the sense of this idea that Laosid Lavoi, we're going to have our chayus from the Ziv of the Eibishter. This is basically the Ramban sensor, and we'll see it this way. The Rebbe spoke about learning by Soros.
We're halfway there.